Everyone, how are you? Yesterday I started subject and predicate. What is subject? The person, place or thing we speaks about, that is subject. And what we speak about the subject, that is predicate. And always a verb will come in the predicate part. And the next part we will start. So here it is. See the students, yesterday I gave these sentences to you and now I am explaining with answer. Understand, underline the subject and encircle the predicate in each of the following sentence. First, John plays snakes and ladders. So, if we will do questions, make question. See, John plays snake and ladders. Who plays snake and ladders? Answer will come, John. Uncle Paul bought some sweets. So who bought sweets? Some sweets? Uncle Paul. So Uncle Paul is subject and the rest part will be predicate. So encircle it, underline the subject. Angela and Amy went to the bench. So who went to the bench? Angela and Amy. So Angela and Amy are subject and went to the bench, predicate. So encircle the predicate. The Thames is a famous river. So which is a famous river? The Thames. Answer will come, the Thames. And the rest part is a famous river is predicate. Then we encircle it. The photographer took beautiful photographs. Means, who took beautiful photographs? Answer will come, the photographer. So the photographer is subject and the rest part will be predicate. The sentences have subject from the before the verb. See, each sentence, John plays, means plays is verb and subject will come before the verb. Uncle Paul bought. Bought is a verb. Uncle Paul, subject. So, in these sentences, I have subjects before the verb. Next, subject is an imperative sentence. Means, how can subject will come in imperative sentence? First of all, we have to know what is imperative sentence. So, a sentence that expresses command, request, order is called imperative sentence. For example, finish your food means I am giving command, finish your food. So you is understand, you finish your food. Go to bed means you go to bed. Run fast means you understood, so you run fast. Hurry up, you hurry up. These are imperative sentence. What is the subject in each of these sentences? So, all these sentences actually means, I have already explained, finish your food means you finish your food. Go to bed means you go to bed. Run fast means you run fast. Hurry up means you hurry up. But you is not stated here. It is understood. In imperative sentence, you is understood. Next, see, rewrite the sentence using subjects. It is these sentence based on the same imperative sentence. So here you is understood. Stand straight means you stand straight. Open your books means you open your books. Cut the fruit means you cut the fruit. Don't move your legs means you don't move your legs. Write in blue ink means you write in blue ink. So, in interrogative sentence, the subject comes after the helping verb. Next, our point, next rule is, in interrogative sentences, the subject comes after the helping verb. So, here is the question word. What is interrogative sentence? So, students, A sentence that ask a question is called interrogative sentence. So in these sentences, helping verb will come before the subject. See, has the train arrived? Means is, am, are, was, were, has, have, had. These are helping verbs, and always helping verb will come before the subject. See, has the train arrived? Has is helping verb. The train is subject, and the arrived verb. Is Mickey unwell? Is helping verb. Mickey unwell. Are the kids sleeping? Are helping verb. The kids, subject, sleeping verb. So all these sentences are in same manner. To find the subject in such sentences, we have to ask question. For example, who is unwell? Mickey is unwell. Who is sleeping? The kids are sleeping. So I have already told you that is, am, are, was, were, has, have, had can be used as a helping verb. Next, match the subject with the suitable predicates to form meaningful sentence. See the first sentence. My dream, and match, is to become an astronaut. So you will match just like the first sentence. Next part. Underline the subject in each of the following interrogative sentence. See, underline the subject. I have already told you that in interrogative sentence, first of all, helping verb will come, then subject will come. Are you going on a picnic? Who is going on a picnic? You are going on a picnic. So you is subject or helping verb. Is Priya the best dancer in the class? So who is best dancer in the class? Priya. So is helping verb and Priya is subject. And the rest part is predicate. Next. You will do these sentences in same manner. So students, this is the chapter on subject and predicate. You will do the exercise of this chapter and revise it. Thank you. Have a nice day.